todos los martes, en punto de las 12, escucha a la doctora Natalia Luraguis en su programa En Consulta. Un show que trata de consejos médicos, salud y belleza, y donde la doctora Luraguis contesta todas tus preguntas. ¡Comenzamos!
Ladies and gentlemen, damas y caballeros, señoras y señores de todas las edades, gracias por estar con nosotros el día de hoy aquí a través de 318 Latino. Thank you so much for being with us on 318 Latino today. We have a very, very special topic. Like every Tuesday, we have En Consulta, which is a show about learning health, medical, spiritual, mental, and it's all about empowering people. Well, on this episode, it's definitely all about empowering people back to work, because we have En Consulta not only La Doctora Luraguis, but we also have Joy Taylor accompanying us today for the second time. And thank you so much, for guys, for being here today with us.
Thank you.
Thank you so much, Joy, for coming today to our show and to be talking today about empowering people and going back to work. Joy nos va a hablar de cómo podemos volver a trabajar, ¿sí? Después de que tuvimos un conflicto con un DWI o algún tipo de adicción o algo por el estilo. Joy today is going to talk with us about three main things. So, Joy, tell us a little bit about what you do again. We had a lot of views in our last interview that we had with Joy. And we had a lot of questions from our community about what he does, but we would like to clarify it in like three simple bullets and las tres cosas in how Joy can help you to get your life back together.
Well, thank you, Natalia, and thank you, Brian, for having me. A development that's happened since the last time we talked is I have set up my company to be dealing with empowering people, and an empowering is also part of the name. The name of my company is Computer Communications Empowerment. And what I do is there's three levels of help that I give or I offer. Most of my clients, like I told y'all last time, are referred to me mm-hmm. by doctors and facilities. One of them is Palmetto in Rayville. I also have a counselor from Shreveport-Bossier area that refers clients to me. But family members and other people that have friends and family members that have lost their jobs due to alcohol or drugs are getting in touch with me because of knowing what I'm doing and offering.
This is so important, guys. So Joy, the way that he, como él nos puede dar la oportunidad de volver a trabajar es a través, ¿cómo le llegan a él sus clientes? Bueno, le llegan a través de familiares que conocen a un hijo o una hija que está teniendo problemas tomando alcohol o está tomando problemas con drogas o teniendo problemas donde ya implican connotaciones policiales, que pueden estar en contacto con Joy, o también pueden ser doctores o pueden ser psicólogos que le están refiriendo estos pacientes o estas personas individuales a Joy para que él las pueda poner de nuevo en el sistema.
So the thing that I do, the three main things, first off, if you've lost your job, then you've lost income. So the first thing that I do is I assist my clients in getting government assistance if it's available to them. That would be like SNAP benefits, like food benefits, Medicaid, Medicare, and unemployment benefits.
O sea que si tu hijo o tu hija perdieron su trabajo por drogas o por adicciones, y son ciudadanos americanos o son ciudadanos de otro país, pero tienen un seguro social, Joy los ayuda a que ellos apliquen para el Medicaid o para la Medicare como seguranza médica, para las estampillas de la comida o para otros tipos de oportunidades laborales.
Para desempleo también.
Para desempleo, exacto.
Now, I'm not offering the benefits. I'm assisting you in applying for the benefits.
Exacto. Joy no es la persona que está ofreciendo los beneficios. Él te está ofreciendo la ayuda para que vos apliques para estos beneficios que los ofrece él sistema americano.
So when a person loses their jobs, they have three tiers of things that they need. First is they need to have subsistence for life. Roof over your head, food in your belly, and medical attention if needed. The next thing that I do is that I assist the client in applying for paperwork for either going back to school, either college or vocational training, or I help them apply for grants to start businesses.
O sea que Joey te puede ayudar en aplicar para tu unemployment, que significa para tu pérdida de trabajo. También te puede ayudar a volver a trabajar. También te puede ayudar para que vos apliques a una beca para poder ir de nuevo a la escuela. Y también te ayuda a aplicar a grants que te pueden dar dinero para empezar pequeños negocios.
So the two levels that we've talked about so far, first was I need to be able to take care of myself physically. The second is I need to be able to prepare myself for what's coming up next. The third area that I deal with is I do training in human resource training and development.
So, y la tercera cosa en la que yo te puedo ayudar es haciendo el entrenamiento en computadoras que él ofrece.
So human resource training and development, so you understand what I do, I basically help you find jobs, but I also help you be prepared for the job. And a lot of jobs now, even working at McDonald's, you're having to deal with more computer work. So what I do is I am certified in the Microsoft Office suite and a whole bunch of other softwares. So what I do is I train the person on the basic level of software, but a lot of corporate jobs and bigger jobs are requiring Excel and Access. I'm certified in those at a higher level than just your regular person. I've taught at Texas A&M where I taught faculty how to use this software. So I also trained them on that, but I will assist them in prepping for interviews.
No es solo que Joy te va a dar una oportunidad para que vos vayas a tener una entrevista para el trabajo, sino que él también te va a preparar para esta entrevista. Por ejemplo, en cómo te ves, en cómo te estás vistiendo, tu manerismo. Y a su vez, si estos trabajos requieren que tengas algún tipo de nivel de computación que tú no tienes, él te puede ayudar a tener ese entrenamiento, porque él era profesor en una universidad en Texas, donde él entrenaba gente con Microsoft, Word, Excel y también muchísimos otros softwares que hoy se pueden usar. Por ejemplo, si aplicas para trabajar en McDonald's o con cualquier otro restaurante, vas a tener que estar más adecuado a prepararte en la parte técnica.
So, the thing that I love about what I'm able to do, and this, even since we talked last time, I have my client base has increased. The thing that I want to express to the viewer and listener right now is I have a sliding scale. I'm not in this for making buku money. I'm just trying to survive and make sure that someone else is surviving along with that.
La filosofía de Joy no es tener este trabajo para hacerte millonario, sino para poder ayudar al otro a sobrevivir, pero que también él pueda sobrevivir haciendo esto.
So with that being said, what I'm offering is, like, I have three clients that signed up with me. I normally charge close to $75 an hour, but the need base took it to where two of them can pay me $20. And another one, I'm doing pro bono.
So, hay veces que Joy, su
so
membresía es como $75 al mes. Pero él también sabe que estas personas por ahí no tienen dinero y le pueden pagar capaz después o capaz puede ajustar ese precio a $25 o algo un poquito menor.
I also... Natalia knows me, and she's known me for quite some time. Having worked at Texas A&M in the Bryan College Station, Brazos Valley area, I have an affinity for the Latin community because of the friends that I made there at Texas A&M, both working there and in the general community.
Joey siempre tuvo como una predisposición a ayudar a la comunidad latina, desde que yo lo conozco, que son muchos, muchos años. Desde que yo vine a Estados Unidos, que fue 2007, o sea, 2007.
It was from 2007 to 2007, I worked
yes.
at Texas
A&M. Yes, yes.
And so I have an affinity for the Latin community because being there, I got to understand more and see more. And I wish I could speak Spanish, but with my Southern accent, my friends in the Latin community told me I shouldn't because it was kind of funny.
Joey, pese a que querramos, no puede hablar español y porque su acento también es bastante peculiar, así que se comunica más que nada en inglés.
Rolling the R's was a really difficult thing.
Yes.
But with that aside, what I'm able to do now, I have clients that come to me that have already started businesses, mm-hmm. and so some of them now that are they're in the sober community, what they're doing is sponsoring for giving me money to go towards people.
Mm-hmm. Hay también un montón de gente que está en la en la AA community, en la comunidad sobria, que ya empezó negocios y que siente que puede compartir un poco de dinero para que otras personas empiecen negocios también y puedan estar sobrios.
So, even if it's an issue that you don't think, I mean, if you're having an issue in trying to find services for anything, there are resources that I have. I don't want to say I'm a social worker, but I have lots of information that is available to me. I've grown up in this area. I've grown up in Louisiana. Shreveport is my hometown. And so I have a lot of resources that I've begun to accumulate and look at. And I've been able to plug people into specific attorneys to deal with different issues. I have accountants that I know. I have a lot of different people, a lot of resources beyond just medical.
Tiene muchos recursos, Joey, para poder ayudar, no solo médicos, sino también con abogados, con contadores, con gente que uno necesita cuando tiene un problema con la ley por abusar una sustancia o por abusar el alcohol.
And so, even if I've helped, like, since the last interview, mm-hmm. I've helped over 6 people get into facilities to get detoxed and to try to get healthy again.
Desde nuestra última entrevista, Joey ayudó a 6 personas a entrar a centros de rehabilitación en esta área para poder tener ayuda.
And so with that knowledge, I'm wanting to share it. I don't want to hold it in. I want to share it and help other people. Hence the reason I have empowerment in the name of my business. So the 3 ways that I help clients that I see or people that I see that come to me for assistance, mm-hmm. the very first thing is
maneras en que él va a ayudar. La primera.
I want to make sure that you're able to eat, that you have a roof over your head, and that you are getting ready for a plan.
Él quiere saber que vos tengas un techo sobre tu cabeza, que tengas comida y que tengas un plan para poder mejorar.
So the next level is then, after that, then we decide, do you need education? Do you need, and if you need education, then what is it going to be? Well, I look at your background. Mm-hmm. Do you need to be working as an air conditioner? A repair person?
Exacto.
Or are you wanting to become a nurse? Or are you wanting to become a teacher?
El segundo nivel es como decidir. ¿Vos querés trabajar o querés volver a estudiar? ¿Querés trabajar como un reparador de aire acondicionado o querés volver a ir a la escuela para poder ser enfermera o maestra?
So, and then after those first 2 levels, the next level is, what do we need to do to get you ready for either vocation or school? Either way, you're going to have to do interviews. So what I will do is I'll teach you how to use the software that you're going to be dealing with. I will give you best practices on how to, when you're doing, this is something that I've learned in my life, just as a regular person, not as an instructor. Mm-hmm. When you go to do applications online, it can time out on you because you're trying to look at your document and then transfer the information over. Well, there's shortcut keys to copying and pasting, and there's also other ways of dealing with your resume. If you've done your resume and you've used Word document to do the template, have you ever tried to edit it after you've done it? If you can't edit it, unless you are an expert in Word, which I am, and even then, I have difficulty doing it.
Yeah.
So what I do is I teach you how to do it where you can copy and paste information over so that you have your resume ready, so that you don't get timed out on government applications and stuff.
Now, entonces, una de las formas en que yo te puedo ayudar es sabiendo. Vos vas a decirte ir de la vía de la vocación diciendo, ok, hoy lo que quiero hacer es ir a reparar aires acondicionados porque eso es lo que me gusta hacer. O ir de la parte de la educación, que es, ok, vamos a prepararte para que vos puedas volver a la escuela para enfermería o para que puedas volver a la escuela para ser maestra o lo que vos tengas ganas de hacer. Y luego, a través de eso, está la tercera parte también, que es preparar tu currículum vitae. O sea, tu currículum vitae se tiene que hacer en la computadora y capaz sigas agregando cosas en ese currículum. Y eso es la parte en donde Joey también te puede ayudar, porque él justamente es un especialista en todo el tema de Microsoft y te puede enseñar trucos para que vos los puedas hacer sin Joey permanentemente.
So what I'm enjoying about what I do is like I can offer classes. If I have more people to take a class, and so as you see, we have our mask on because of the coronavirus. One of the things that I offer is online Zoom classes.
Y como ahora tenemos el coronavirus y no está tan como bueno juntarse socialmente sin mascarilla o con mascarilla por ahí, Joey ofrece esto a través de Zoom, que es una aplicación que puedes bajar en tu celular y luego están carita a carita, pero de una forma safe.
And so I also can take over your computer so that I can manipulate your application for you so that I can show you where you need to go in the application. Say if you're in Word and you're having a problem with your resume and you can't get it to work, I'm looking at your screen. You give me access to it, and I maneuver your mouse for you virtually, and we get it taken care of.
Y virtualmente, él puede entrar a tu computadora y ayudarte a teclear todo lo que vos necesites.
But when the Zoom is over, I have no control of your computer.
Pero después, cuando el Zoom termina, él no tiene más control sobre tu computadora. That's a really good, an important explanation, not to be answering anybody's text or message.
It's only for during the course.
Right. Only during the course, yes.
So solo durante el curso. So you can't blame me whenever something messes up afterwards.
Yes, exactly.
My bank accounts are empty. What happened?
I have no control over that. So what I'm excited about, too, and I wanted to wait until today,
yes,
I'm going to launch my Facebook with Brian and Natalia today.
We are so excited about that. Ooh. Joey has done his Facebook page, and we're going to be sharing his Facebook page, and we're going to be giving likes. So
the thing about this, everyone, the doctor is not supposed to be the doctor for themselves.
Right.
Okay. When you're doing your own Facebook and your own website, you're very picky and you get paralyzed. So now I know how my clients feel.
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
So when you see the picture and you see the Facebook come up, please don't make fun of me too terribly much.
No, it's going to be perfect. We know so, it. We look so excited.
With that said, I'm going to go ahead and launch it this very minute because I'm hyperactive.
That's great.
And I've been wanting to do it.
So we're like launching live right now Joey's Facebook page for his new business. So, todos podemos comunicarnos con Joey a través de Facebook ahora porque estamos lanzando en vivo su página de Facebook. Así que toda la gente que tenga preguntas en cómo ayudar a tu hijo, cómo ayudar a tu hija, si están abusando de drogas o abusando de alcohol, o si tú eres una persona que se da cuenta que necesita ayuda, por favor, conéctate con nosotros. Para eso estamos. Yo, desde mi lado médico, en You Are Access MD, estamos más que felices de poder ayudar a nuestros pacientes a encontrar una oportunidad para estar sobrios y poder ayudarlos con muchas oportunidades y recursos. Y gente como Joey, que tenemos hoy en nuestra comunidad, que son una bendición, que nos pueden dar la oportunidad de volver a la escuela. Todos cometemos errores, todos cometemos una mala decisión. No dejes que tu vida cambie para siempre por una decisión que tomaste, ¿ok? Hoy tenemos la oportunidad en 318 Latino con la comunidad hispana que Brian y Vita siempre están cultivando y siempre están educando. Hoy tenemos la oportunidad desde el lado médico, desde el lado de los recursos humanos, de poder cambiar nuestra vida. Y nadie te está pidiendo $15,000 para hacerlo. Esta es una invitación de Dios, una invitación de nuestra comunidad para que tu vida mejore. Así que, por favor, nunca dudes en conectarte con nosotros, con Brian, conmigo, con Joey. Estamos acá para ayudarte, porque de la manera en que nosotros nos mantenemos bien es pudiendo ayudar al otro, pudiendo salir de nuestro propio problema, de nuestro propio encierro o nuestra propia negatividad. Si nos quedamos dentro de eso, solo vamos a encontrar más negatividad. Si tenemos la oportunidad de ayudar a otro, es una invitación para poder darte cuenta el potencial que tenés como ser humano. Así que nunca te olvides que el potencial que tenemos es ilimitado. Y no importa lo que hiciste antes, no importa lo que te pasó ayer. ¿Para qué te vas a preocupar de lo que te pasó ayer si no estás valorando hoy? Hoy es siempre la oportunidad para empezar de nuevo, chicos. Para todos, ¿ok?
The one thing that I'm really excited about as well, I know I've been saying one thing, so several things that I'm excited about, but one of them is I love children. I don't do advocacy, but I have a nonprofit that is wonderful in helping children with special needs get education, to get their needs met.
Joey tiene una gran vocación para los niños también, y hay recursos para los niños con ¿cómo sería la traducción, Brian, en español? De habilidades especiales.
Correcto.
¿Cómo sería la
traducción? Con necesidades especiales.
Con necesidades especiales, como por ejemplo dislexia.
Learning disabilities, physical disabilities.
Cerebral palsy, alguna que otra... retardo mental, chicos que son especiales y necesitan más recursos para poder llegar al mismo outcome. Por ejemplo, un niño con dislexia no aprende de la misma forma que aprende un niño sin dislexia.
Correcto.
No significa que este niño es más inteligente porque no tiene dislexia. Este niño necesita aprender de una forma especial. Y este niño seguramente tenga el IQ más alto que el niño sin dislexia. Pero igual, hay que saber cómo darle a tu niño esa forma para poder aprender, para que tenga la misma oportunidad que un niño sin dislexia.
And so, one of my clients, she was referred to me, and she's wanting to go back to school, but her mindset was her baby needing to go to school.
Right.
Legally, she has to get the baby into school, but the school was putting up roadblocks because of being a special needs child. And so the resource that I have is called TEAMS, TEAMS. And I'll have, they're one of the nonprofits that you will see on my Facebook, and I will be promoting them. So what I'm going to be doing,
what do they do, Joey, Teams?
What Teams does is they help get the 504s ready, the action plans, And they help students that are have legal problems as well. The juvenile system will refer students that have gotten in trouble with the law to teens as well. And so what ends up happening is my resource there, Cassie helps the student becomes have everything in play for them to become successful.
Okay.
The parent and the child have to have somebody that knows the system.
Yeah.
And so what they do is what she does and her team, what her team does at Teams,
mm-hmm.
is she gathers the family together, gets the information together, and then represents the student to the legal system or to the school board or to the schools, individual schools.
O sea que hay muchos escenarios. Puede que vos seas una mamá que tiene adicciones y que tiene un niño con necesidades especiales. Vos querés volver a la escuela o te querés ir a trabajar, pero no sabés qué hacer con este niñito con necesidades especiales. Ahí es cuando viene Joy, cuando vienen los recursos que él tiene, como por ejemplo este recurso llamado Teams, que te puede ayudar a encontrar ayuda para este niñito con necesidades especiales para que puedas volver al sistema. Y la segunda opción para usar Teams es que tu hijo, por ejemplo, estuvo en juvenile, que significa cuando un niño menor de edad tiene connotaciones legales con la policía por un trastorno de la conducta o porque adicción te puede pasar a cualquier edad. No es necesario que empezaste a tomar a los 21 años. Hay chicos, sobre todo en nuestros países, en la comunidad latina, que empiezan a tomar a los 8 o 11 años. O sea, seamos sinceros, ¿no? O sea, todos sabemos que no hay edad para entrar en un problema de adicciones, ¿no? O sea, que cuando uno es chiquito y tuvo un problema con adicciones, ¿qué pasa? Lo que pasa es que este niño necesita ayuda. Y Joy también puede ayudar a niños menores.
So what you're going to be seeing on my Facebook is resources.
Lo que vas a ver en la página de Facebook de Joy van a ser los recursos.
You're going to see the Deaf Action Center. Whenever they have some events coming up, you'll be seeing that. You'll see the Philadelphia Center for the LGBTQ community. You're going to be seeing, stuff dealing with taxes during tax season.
Vas a ver cosas que pueden ser desde los taxes para ver cómo ayudarte a hacer tus propias taxes, como gente, abogados, ayuda médica, con doctores, o el centro de Filadelfia que tenemos aquí, que es para toda la comunidad con HIV o que quiere prevenir HIV y que tiene algún tipo de riesgo para también tener esa comunidad.
Mm-hmm. And so what I'm,
different communities from everything.
Everything, so that, because everything affects everything. And so,
todo afecta a todo, exacto.
And
what
so,
a deep thing, right? But it's true. Everything affects everything, right?
And we've seen that with the pandemic.
Yes, we saw that. Vimos esto con el coronavirus, cómo todo transforma, cómo todo afecta a todo. And we also saw with our life experiences and with the years, you know, and with the knowledge that life gives you, how everything is transformed. Nothing is perfect and constant all the time. Todo se transforma en la vida, todo. The only thing that is constant in life
is change.
Change, and that everything transforms. So don't judge yourself because you messed up one day, okay? Or if you notice there is a pattern, just know that everything is going to change. La vida se pone buena, la vida se pone mala. La buena se pide, buena, mala. Pero nadie tiene la vida perfecta, permanentemente. Entonces, cuando necesitamos estos recursos, sepan que están aquí para ayudar.
So one of the reasons why I brought up Teams was because of my background. There's two ways that I see myself assisting people. the two ways that I've assisted people in my past were I helped them with education. The second way that I've worked in my past has been to help people spiritually and with work. So that's three, if you will, there. But the reason I am passionate about helping children and helping people find resources is when I was young, I was diagnosed with a learning disability. I shared that last time. My mother had to find resources. After she found the resources, as a real estate agent, she didn't just try to sell a house. She was trying to help the community. And my father, as a finance man, whenever someone came to him and they are wanting to get a loan for a car, but they're having problems with their job, he would help them find a job so that they could pay his loan. But it wasn't about paying the loan when he saw kids needing help. And so for me, I want to do that for my life now that I've gotten older and I'm more mature.
Yes.
I'm still not mature, but I've gotten older. But what I want to do is if someone is coming to me and they're wanting to get a job, they can't think about a job or they can't think about going to school when their wife, their baby, their mother, their father, or a close family friend is hurting.
Yeah. That is so important. That is so important.
And so what I want to do is to help people plug in so that they have power.
Yeah.
Hence empowerment.
Yes.
So the three areas that I work with for my business, first level, get you some food, get you some benefits, get you some medical. Second level is, do we get education? Or do we just go straight to vocation? If we go straight to vocation.
It's straight to work.
If we're going straight to work, then what I do is I try to help you find positions based upon your resume.
The right job.
And plugging you into a place, not just so that you can have a job, but that you can have a career.
Right. Mm-hmm.
There's a difference between making a 9-to-5 and then finding what you want to do.
Right.
If you find, my dad said, if you find what you love to do, if it's digging a ditch, it won't be work.
Be fun.
Yeah. And helping people is always fun. Helping others is always fun. Always. Every person that needs your help is a new adventure, you know? The way that Joey can help you is not just you. It's like if you have kids, if you are a single mom and you have three kids and one of your kids has a learning disability or needs a different care or a different way to learn, he can help you with that too.
I can help you find the resource.
Yes.
I want to plug you into the proper resources.
Exactly. That's what he does. Offers you the resources. He will not be the psychologist or the person doing it, but he will guide you to what you need.
Because I have a whole bunch of people that life that I'm blessed with, like Natalia and Brian, that I now know have the same mindset of wanting to help more than just myself.
Right.
And so that's the beauty that this is by helping you, you're empowering me.
Yes. Wow. That's exactly. This is how it works. It's like by helping other, you know? It's like sometimes people will tell me, oh, Dr. Natalia, she doesn't want to call you. I don't want to text you because you're always so busy. And I always tell them, like, as soon as you did text me or as soon as you call me, it's just taking me out of myself
right.
to give. So what is better than that, right? And I now have a girl that calls me because she didn't want it to call me, you know how that goes. And I told her, you know, I said, like, just do it for me.
Right.
Just check, call me to let me know you're doing okay. Just because it helps me. So, well, if it's going to help you, I better start doing it then.
Right.
So it's great. Like, and helping others is always great.
And Natalia being my friend, I will do anything to help her out. But here lately, as a doctor, she's helped me on so many different levels. And I am just grateful that I have somebody that's in my corner, because I don't have to worry now about health issues that I was having, because she stepped in and knows me, knows my background, knows my family background, and it makes me feel safer. And so that's what I want to be able to do to help somebody else. One of my teachers said the best teacher is a teacher that teaches themselves out of a job.
Right. Because they're teaching the other people how to do it.
And so that's what I want. I want you to spread your wings, because that's empowering.
Right.
And what's so good about that is if you have been empowered, you become empowering.
Yes, you do.
It becomes contagious. It's a good thing.
It's a good contagious. Right. Not a coronavirus contagious. It's a good state to be contagious.
Right. And so,
you know?
And so that, as I'm sitting here discussing this with y'all, it's reminding me of what I'm supposed to be doing. As a human being, I'm supposed to be connecting. And if I can connect to one person and help one person become successful, then I've done buku more than I expected. So, like my Facebook, show up on 318 Latino.
Share it, because comparte el Facebook de Joey, because maybe someone else needs the help.
And as I'm thinking about this too, this is the one thing I want to say to you. Just because I'm here in Shreveport doesn't mean I don't have connections all over the country.
Right.
Yes.
Because that's one thing about having
even our Texas people, please.
Yeah, I've got friends all over the country. I have a huge family that I have from Michigan to the bottom of Florida, all the way over to California, up into Washington and Alaska. So, and when I traveled working for Texas A&M, I was in the Heathrow Airport waiting for my flight to Doha, Qatar, and all of a sudden, I was laughing. I have a goofy laugh, I snort. It's very obvious when Joey's in the building. And two friends hollered out, "Joey!" from opposite ends of the run of the area that I was walking through. And I had friends in the Heathrow Airport that I didn't even know were in there. One was from high school and one was from my master's program. So you never know who I'm going to know.
Yes, that's a good problem to have. Es un buen problema de tener. Joey, it's always a pleasure to have you here. We're going to do like a monthly special, because this is such a great, you know, great resource, you know. It's so, so important. And to find that safe place that Joey was talking about, you know, you have to find that safe place with your doctor, but you know, you also have to find it with a friend. Right. Or like, you know, that's how I feel about one of my friends, you know, Heather is her name. And like, you know, it doesn't matter what is going around, and it doesn't matter what is happening in my life. When I am with her, I know that I'm safe and that everything will be okay, you know? And the same thing is with what Joy does. This is going to be your safe place. We're telling or asking for help, you're not going to be judged. You're going to be giving tools for that to be an invitation to empower yourself to a much better circumstance in life. And start seeing the blessings coming, you know? That's how life is. Remember, it's always an up and a down. So even if you were in a super up, be grateful that you are on it, but share these resources for someone that needs that help today. One person that we can help today, Brian, me, Joy, it will just make our day. So I hope that this reach to that person that truly needs it. And with that, I will let so the joy close this beautiful, beautiful, beautiful opportunity that we had today.
I'm Joey Taylor. I have a business. It's called Computer Communications Empowerment. I want to help you, help yourself. Get in touch with me.
I love it. Like Joey's page, share his Facebook page, and reach out to him. She's here to help you, as we all are. Have a great Tuesday, guys. We all love you.
And that's the show, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you so much for joining us. And again, Joy, thank you for everything you're doing for the community.
Thank you.
Natalia, muchísimas gracias.
Oh, gracias a vos, Brian, como siempre.
Y hasta la próxima, damas y caballeros.